So for a change, I'm going to talk about a change. I'm not going to pitch a product. I need to be here. And let's take a step back and think why we are doing all this, why we build applications, for whom we are doing it. Right? So most important person in the whole ecosystem is not us. It's not the technology. Technology is not a person. That's not the ingredient. We are doing it all for our users. They are the important person. They consume the applications. So the users are changing. They are demanding more. They are looking for better experience. And that's why we are building applications and we are changing our applications. And then come us, the developers. So we also need to change. And that's what we are going to talk about. And that's why we are here. And the other component that is infrastructure, that is also changing, like from data centers to now microservices, Dockers, cloud, so many things. So that's what we are here, and that's what we are talking about. And that's again a change that we are talking about security here in the changing application trends. The business models are also changing, the DevOps practices coming in, and so on. But are we only changing, or somebody else is also changing? Attackers are also changing. We have seen WannaCry. After so long, people figured out, OK, some vulnerability and started attacking. And here's how I am changing. I started with a company called Mojo Networks in Wi-Fi security domain, went to the social shopping domain in Zinrelo, and now work with A10 Networks. So let's start. So one more thing that is changing, but in little wrong direction, and that we need to change is the perception. Perception about we as a developer. So there was a survey done by A10. And 50%, almost 50%, not exactly 50%, the organizations think that their developers are not serious about security. We all know that's wrong, but that's the perception we are living into. And we need to change that. Not just we need to work for security, but we need to make sure that people understand we are working for security. So we make applications secure so that people can trust on us. So how many of us, by the way, here think that applications are secure in the cloud? Nobody thinks that way? OK, at least one. So everybody else thinks that applications are more secure in the data centers. Is that the case? Or we are becoming lazy here? Most of people, I think, are becoming lazy. Some hands there. OK. So let's see how the survey report, it's not done by A10, some other general survey company. And in this case, 60% of people actually say that they feel applications are secure in the cloud. Why this perception? That's a different thing. And 30% people are saying no, they are not. And 13% of people are still unsure, like, OK, I don't know. So let's go here, whether it's cloud, like public clouds, or whether it's the cloud environment provided by our own team. But let's consider them same and then figure out how we can do it, how we can create a complete system so that ultimately the whole thing is secure and users are happy, their data is safe, and everything. So let's come to that and see when we consider that application is secure. So very simple three things. Whenever somebody wants to access the application, he should be able to. And only the person who is the legitimate user should be able to access. And the third simple thing is the data. That's all is required, nothing more than this. Right? Anybody differs? Okay. So now when we need to achieve this, now there are infrastructure and code, two major parties. And let's see what the public cloud providers say in this area. How can we secure? Whose responsibility is this? See, Azure and AWS are like major biggest partners. And of course, Cisco is coming up with dCloud Orchestrator, and Google is coming up with cloud, and so many other else have the cloud. But clearly, it is mentioned that it's a shared responsibility. Some areas here, and in the case of AWS also, some responsibility is when they say customer is we as developer, who is AWS customer. They have the responsibility of security. So if we carefully look into it, it is more like what layers, who manages what layers. So let's look into this as from the network stack point of view, from the technology, coming back to the technology point of view. It's a very familiar stack, right? And why this stack? Because the applications are deployed somewhere, and users, as well as attackers, are accessing it using the network. And that's why network stack. So if we are able to secure the complete stack, the access to all of this, then things are going to be secure. So the first, the physical layer is completely managed by cloud service providers or IT teams or infrastructure teams. And they need to take care of, they do take care of it. In case of cloud, it's their sole job. I'm going to come to that. Next one is the networking. And again, the physical networking, like cables and everything, that is, again, cloud team or the infrastructure team. But now, networks are becoming virtual. And virtual networks, again, come to the developer or DevOps, the application team, basically. They need to take care of it. And then the application. Then service providers or infrastructure providers, they don't understand it. They just provide the infrastructure, and then we as a developer, we as application owners need to manage it, need to secure it completely. So it's completely our responsibility. They don't even talk about it. Let's take a little deep dive and then say why and how the infrastructure can be made secure. And this comes the various certifications that these public cloud providers obtain. That's why they are secure, and that's why maybe the perception is that, okay, cloud is secure. If we manage it, the infrastructure ourselves, our team also need to do the same. And then the security part, means this, so many talks are happening on network security, and everybody's thinking for so long, the best practices of networking are so well induced into us that whenever we try to build a network, be it physical or virtual, we always go by that. Okay, we have to have an IP firewall, and we have to have an IPS, and so on. So that's already there. Then the best practices of application security. Write good code, take good libraries and everything, and I say, yes, we all do that. But is that make us completely secure? No attack happens, and is always about application, always about writing good code. Again, let's see the data once again. This is malware injection that has to do something like some backdoor by which some software gets installed, like WannaCry or something. No matter how secure we want to go, how patch apply and everything, something goes here and there. And then if we see, like, denial of service attacks, and that has nothing to do with how good we do, we keep our application. People are going to attack. People are going to attack at network layer. People are going to attack at application layer. Attacks are going to happen. And attacks are also changing. Attackers are trying to do as much as possible, multiple vectors, and which vector they find little weak, the attack happens from there. The other change that is happening is, earlier it used to be like, okay, we do the attack, figure out what's the problem there, adapt the attack, and then go. Boom the service. Now what is happening is this is everything together. Oh, some place or the other, some vulnerability will be there, and as quickly as possible, we go ahead and attack the service. So we also need to build accordingly. And then we talked about some traffic portions, like bot, traffic from bots. So many people say, okay, that's not security problem. That's fine. They are not going to steal anything. Our application is going to run fine. But about 30% of traffic now is from bots. So if we do not secure our application against bots, then 30% of our capacity is going waste. What is the whole point? The other thing, again, because we are building everything for users and they are becoming impatient, they don't wait for application page to load for long. So we need to respond faster. And that's another challenge that organizations are finding. And with the growth of this microservices architecture and cloud, the distributed networking, distributed applications. So applications are deployed here and there. Now it is becoming challenging that, OK, you go in each and every instance and configure it and see what's happening there. So central management is becoming another challenge. So in this context, one company, one of our customers, I can't take the name, but they came to us at ATA and they're, OK, we have an application deployed in cloud. We have a load balancer, or maybe we have a little higher than layer 7 load balancer. Now we understand that we need to take care of security. So let's do something. Can you give us the security product? We said, fine, OK. Then what you will do for the visibility portion? So finally, this is how they thought of doing it. So OK, we'll put some security, and then we will put some monitoring. And then we'll put some acceleration, and then traffic management that they already had. And on top of it, they want, finally, this like elastic infrastructure is required, so elasticity at each layer. So finally, this is how their architecture was. Complicated. They need to put multiple layers, multiple products, and then stitch them together, get data from one, push it to other, and so on. What we provided is the simplest simplified architecture. They started with security, so they got security, plus simplified architecture, plus operational efficiency, and so on. So that's how, rather than focusing on individual technology and individual product, it is about how we can put them together and make it simple, not just for us, but also for our end customers. Ultimately, the goal is the users and the applications and their data that has to be good, secure. So let me introduce quickly about what the product does. We call it Lightning Application Delivery System. This is the data plane component. This is built on SDN architecture. So the data plane component and management is separate. And the traffic goes via the data plane, of course. And management can reside outside. And actually, A10 provides it as SaaS. And not just security, but it also gives the elasticity, the visibility, the traffic management, and all those things in as a single product. Coming back to the topic, that when we surveyed, not this agency surveyed the companies, what they want to do. So top priority is they want to do application security monitoring and a web application firewall. So that's like high level check mark. But what exactly happens? Like how we do it, what are the nitty-gritties of it? Maybe we discuss it not today. Maybe we discuss it tomorrow in the workshop session. For now, let's have it like three simple key takeaways. The infrastructure is taken, it should be taken care by the infrastructure team or cloud service providers, and complete focus in there and build a robust infrastructure there. Networking, physical, they'll take care of, and we as application owners need to take care of the virtual networking. And application security is our responsibility, and that's where the users trust us. Actually, according to the survey, around 50% of the users think that the security should be taken care of by developers or their IT teams. So they trust on us. They trust in our applications. So it becomes our like moral duty to live up to that. And we need to make effort so that users are happy and keep trust in our application, keep trust in us. So the whole thing can remain secure as much as we can. So we need to go ahead. We need to make sure that things remain secure and we are not giving away the keys to somebody else. Thank you. Anything?
Thank you, Akshay.